They're the largest snakes on Earth, roaming the Amazon. They've eaten goats, deer, and even crocodiles. So, what would happen if an anaconda tried to eat you? Can an anaconda really swallow a human? How long would you be traveling through the snake's body? And has something like this happened before? This is What If? And here's what would happen if you were swallowed by an anaconda. Believe it or not, in 2014, someone was actually dumb enough to attempt this. He was wearing a large, bulky suit covered in pig's blood. The anaconda worked for an hour, wrapping its mouth around the head of the suit, but it was ultimately unsuccessful in swallowing the human whole. If it had been successful, how would an anaconda be able to eat a full-sized adult? So, you happen to be wandering in the Amazon rainforest and you stumble upon one of these giant anacondas. Green anacondas grow up to 9 meters in length and can weigh as much as 225 kilograms. You might think you'd be a tasty meal to them, as a small meal for an anaconda is about 18 kilograms. If they were to gobble you up, it would keep them satisfied for weeks. But a meal over 45 kilograms, like you, might not be what an anaconda is most interested in. Due to how massive you are, not to mention being taller and broader than most animals it eats, you would take too long to consume. This, in turn, would leave the anaconda vulnerable to predators for weeks, if not months, until it finishes digesting you. But let's say it did want to eat you. What would happen then? Well, before an anaconda swallows you, it would kill you first. An anaconda is a constrictor snake, and it kills by wrapping its body all around its prey and quickly crushing them to death with over 9,000 pounds of pressure. It would be a pretty quick end for you. But we all know that's not how this show works. So let's assume you survive this, and we get to see the entire process. The anaconda would then widen its jaw to swallow you whole. You won't have to worry about it chewing you up into little bits, since it only has fangs used for holding its prey. And luckily, as opposed to other snakes, the anaconda isn't venomous, so its fangs won't poison and paralyze you. But something you will find in the anaconda's mouth is lots and lots of saliva. Yeah, this will be used to moisten you. You know, so it's easier for the anaconda to slide you down their gullet. So now you're moving down the snake's esophagus. As with many other animals, the muscles in the esophagus will push you down the snake's body. The anaconda also has the ability to move and bend its ribs to crush you even further and push you down into its stomach. Okay, now you're in the anaconda's stomach. Don't worry, we're still keeping you alive. You know, to make this more fun. The anaconda's stomach produces powerful acids and stomach enzymes that will dissolve your skin, and then eventually your bones. How fast do these acids work exactly? Well, an anaconda once dissolved an alligator's skin in just 3 days, so your squishy, fleshy skin would disappear pretty quickly. Your body would break down even further as you move through the snake's small intestine. That's due to the liver and pancreas secreting even stronger enzymes. Everything besides your hair and your nails would be digested at this point. And even if you were wearing some magical suit that protected you from the acid and everything else, it would still be a couple of weeks before you were unceremoniously pooped out. So it's likely you'd starve. Although something like this is incredibly unlikely. Just leave anacondas alone. After all, they aren't interested in eating you in most cases, as you're just too big. They're really just trying to defend themselves. Plus, you'd pretty much die instantly if you tried to mess with one of these things. Another thing you probably shouldn't be messing with are whales. And you definitely shouldn't be jumping into their stomachs, but we'll leave that story for another What If?